Welcome to all our students and teachers to the third session of this online orientation for students on the topic of how to score good marks in SSC board examination. From 1st of December till 11th of December, we have organized this online orientation class for standard 10th students. Each day we'll be covering one subject. I hope that the entire portion of our SSC students from that respective school is completed by your respective teachers. And from 13th of December, most probably, we are going to start our practice papers, prelim practice papers. So we thought before students are appearing for prelim practice papers, we thought as a last minute, some ammunition should be given to you. Given in your hand. So we thought of organizing these experts lectures. All our expert lectures for all the subjects. They are renowned teachers from very reputed schools. They are having experience of more than 20 years. Some of them are teaching in the respective schools. And also they are teaching their own standard 10th students. Some of the students, some of the research persons are also moderators. So being a moderator, they are very well aware how the maximum marks are scored by our students. So here they are ready to help and guide our students on the topic of history today. We are having Josh sir. Josh sir is from KVK Sarvajanik High School, Ghatkopar, and the principal of that school, Mr. Indarkar. He is very good friend of mine, and we are thankful to Mr. Indarkar sir only because of his initiative. We have arranged this galaxy of lecturers from various schools. So Josh sir, please convey my heartfelt thanks to your HM, and on behalf of MCGM Secondary Education English Medium, I warmly welcome our today's guest lecturer, Mr. George. Mr.
Thank Josh, you, sir.
I hope you will guide our students, and with the help of your guidance, our students will be able to score good marks in our history subjects. Thank you. Thank you all. Roshali madam, over to you.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir, for your valuable guidance. Now I request Ms. Bhavya Pujari to introduce today's guest lecturer, Mr. Robin George. Over to you, Bhavya ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Good evening, respected dignitaries, teachers, and all my dear students. On behalf of Brihan Mumbai Municipal Corporation, Education Department, Secondary, it gives me an immense pleasure to welcome Robin George, sir, as a guest lecturer for today's orientation program on History and Political Science for Standard 10. Sir, have been teaching in KVK Ghatkopar Sarvajanik School and Junior College since 23 years. Robin George sir have pursued post-graduation in management of education. Sir has been a board examiner for 13 years and a moderator for 8 years. Sir is also a resource person for Standard 9 and Standard 10 History and Political Science subject. Sir, it's really an honor to have you here among us, and your valuable guidance will definitely help and motivate our Standard 10 students to score well in their upcoming board exam. Yes, ma'am. Roshali ma'am?
Yes, yes. Thank you, Bhavya ma'am, for your wonderful words. So before we start with our today's presentation, there are few instructions for our participants. Firstly, you may ask your questions and queries only at the end of the session by raising your hand. And secondly, attendance link will be provided in chat box at the end. So be present for the entire session, as your attendance will be considered for internal evaluation. So on this note, let us start with today's session. So over to you, George, sir. Kindly,
yeah, thank you.
Kindly share the PPT. Thank you, sir.
Okay. Yeah, thank you, first of all, for giving me this opportunity. The entire team of Brihan Mumbai Mahanagar Secondary Section School and Department Secondary Section, Before I begin my PPT presentation and the guidance for the students, I would like to just thank the honorable dignitaries who are on the part of this guidance lecture. I really like the sessions which you have been organizing for the students, which have been planned out so well. I will especially thanks the Rokhle sir. Definitely, I will convey regards to our principal sir, Shri Jagdish Indalkar sir. I thanks our principal Indalkar sir too also for giving me this platform and an opportunity to be a part of this guidance lecture for the school and wonderful students and the entire team. I thank the superintendent, that is Mr. Honorable Shah sir, Honorable Jadhav sir, who is AO, then Vishali madam, the CNO, then Tawde madam, CNO, Kulkarni sir, and all the other dignitaries who are part of this, Rao madam, the deputy EO secondary section, everyone who are part of this wonderful part of conducting for the benefit of the students lectures. Very nice. So once again, I thank the entire dignitaries and the teacher staff who are part of this history session today. Well, children, I'll begin with my session. With just a few showing with the PPT. Before that, I would like to tell one thing, that history which is there is a concept which is, if you have seen the textbook, it's not like a 8th or a 9th. It's means different textbook that has come up. And if you see already, there is the scope of history has been told to you in very nicely. Okay. And so when you come to as a guidance lecture, the main thing I would be as a moderator, as a resource person, when we evaluate the paper, see, children, when you write a paper, the main thing is your presentation. That's the first part. Remember, when your paper has to be the well presentation. It's like, you know, the first impression is the last impression. Second point, just make a note of your handwriting. See that you write in a very good, clean, eligible handwriting. That is very, very important. Any paper, I would say, any subjects, basically, these are the main tips I would like to give you. Third, avoid cancellations. Be very neat, systematic, so that the examiner, the moderator is going to evaluate a paper, they can definitely feel happy to see your paper and to evaluate your paper. That is a problem. And the main another part I would say, read the history textbook. That's my, I would say, the keen emphasizes on all the students who are part of this lecture, that read thoroughly your history textbook, because as I will show you the PPT and my slides, you'll understand that why the textbook reading is very important. So that is, these are the main thing I would like to tell. And before submitting the paper, just go through your entire paper. And when you're solving the paper, don't solve randomly. Solve with question number 1, 2, 3, 4 in sequence. Well, these are the things, if you remember and you are positive and you are well prepared, you will be definitely able to get go through it. And so I would say, practice papers, write and check, write, solve at least 3 or 4 specimen papers. Do solve yourself and give to your history teachers to evaluate. That is one of the preparation way, a method of evaluating your own performances. So I think rather than much wasting time, we'll just go with the presentation of my PPT and with the first slide I'll just show to you. Okay, just 1 second. That's the first. Okay, just before we go, just try to understand the pattern of the paper which you have been going to give the exam. Already, as I got from the beat officer, Rokhle sir, the Honorable Rokhle sir, that your exam is lining up very soon after this guidance lectures of all the subjects. See, already the paper pattern the board has set up is like, you know, worksheet. It's an activity-based project. It's a kind of a where you have children's have been given more application-based questions will come, their skills will be tested, their knowledge will be tested. So the reason I was telling you to read textbook is because some of the questions will be not just from behind textbook. Usually what children do, they read only textual backside question. No, in history paper, I would preferably prefer that you read thoroughly your textbook and the entire worksheet. We call it as activity worksheet over your history paper, which is allotted 40 marks. 2 hours paper will be there for you. It's divided into 2 parts. 28 marks will be your history. 12 marks will be given for a political science over there. If you see the second point over there, there is a constructivism and students activity. I mean, you have to design such a way that you have to think the question like as I come up with my questions, I'll show you where the child has to use his own individual thinking, his understanding the concepts, his what his skill, the knowledge behind that he has learned. So he can utilize in this part over here. Weightage is given to every question. If your paper patterns, see when you are learning a paper, appearing for the exam, always analyze the paper patterns. Go through the pattern of the paper pattern. What are the optional questions? What are the total, which subject the weightage is more is given? All these things I will be showing just now to you also. Then given to every question, objective should be taken into consideration. Yes. Now what is the part over here? Objective questions. In your history paper, if you just calculate 40 marks paper, you have 12 to 16 marks objectives. If you are very thorough with an objectives, you can easily get those marks. So once I show you the first question, I'll talk about attitude. Then long answers are designed to promote your thinking. Because if you see chapters like, applied history, then we have a tourism chapters, many chapters, which have been such a question, chapters have been framed where you have to promote your thinking, your way of thinking. As a student of Tencel, what do you think history from your point of view? And it's giving you an opportunity to express your views. It is not just that whatever we the bookish answer. It is where child understanding the concept of history and what is he feels. There are some questions will be going to come. They are called as open-ended questions. So where you can just express your views and the credit of marks will be given as per your analysis you have done over there. So let's do the next part. See, open-end questions, checking knowledge, understanding of history should be included for question-based passage. Like you have one passage wheel coming up. So the teacher or the paper setter, he knows that the student is going to write a history paper with, so we will check that how much did you understand those concepts, whether it may be a long answer, maybe a right short note, like short note on a radio, maybe or a television, maybe on a feminine historiography, maybe. So we will judge you. The paper will be evaluated in that way also. It is from the child's point of view. Then developing enough worksheet scope. Like you have a good application-based questions where you have to apply your knowledge, the skills. So weightage is given for that also. So it's like, rather than like, not like a war, First World War, Second World War. It's like, based on your reality. There's some of the topics are so connected with the present situation, the past, and the how it's going to happen. So how history has been changed. So that's why the history curriculum has been framed such a way it's so well that you can really, once you understand the concept, definitely you will be able to solve the paper very systematically. And if you're well prepared, you will be able to score very, very good marks. In fact, as a moderator, I've seen children are getting 38, 40 out of 40 also. I will be just sharing, once I start sharing my slide. Both history and political questions have to be solved in the same answer book. That is the same answer book you have to solve. It's a very common thing which you should know that history and political science is combined. It's a part of the history and political science. Yeah. Now, chapters which have been reduced, 25% had been reduced this year also for you. Chapter number 4 and chapter number 6. That is, chapter 4 is history of Indian arts. Chapter 6 is entertainment. The chapter which is there that has been reduced. And political science, chapter number 5 has been deleted. It's not there only. No questions will be asked for your board exam from this particular chapter. That's the 25% reduced portion. So you have out of the 9 history chapters, 7 political science, out of the 5, you have 4 chapters. So it's a very compact, portion you have for your, I would say, for your upcoming board examination compared to the other curriculum of other subjects. See, all questions are compulsory. That's the first, I almost want to tell you that. Write questions, the diagrams, activities, whatever you draw will be given full marks. Like diagrams are there for you, concept maps are there, timeline is there, flowcharts are there. So this question is your marks. This is your marks, I mean to say. If you just follow the instructions and you draw very neatly, very systematically, draw with the pen, write with the pen the answers, no examiners, no moderators will cut marks. You will get full 2 marks, 4 marks, whatever is assigned to 2 marks. These are called as the objective marks. So this is your marks. So when you how to practice and prepare at the end of the session, before that I will guide you that also. Then question number 1 to 5 are based on history. When you see the question paper, Question 1 to 5 is based on history, and the last three segments, that is 6 to 9, are based on political science over there. Question 2A, question 2A and 8B, the appropriate answer is expected to be written by pen only in concept, ma'am. This is the diagrams, okay? So diagram, it has to be written in a pen, the answers. Most of the time we have come across children, they draw with the pencil and they write with the pencil the answer. It's not correct. You will not get marks. You may lose zero. You may get zero marks also. So basically, I come to this question, when I show you this particular question, that it has to be in pen written. Yeah, this is the entire layout of the paper pattern which we have. The first will be question one. Choose the correct option from the given option and rewrite the statement. 3 out of 3 marks. 3 options will be 3 for you. Question 1 will be identify the wrong pair with the following sets. Here you don't have to correct the pair, my dear children. I will go in detail at a later stage. Again, 3 marks are there for you. Question 2A, complete the concept map. Any 2 out of 3. Again, diagrams are there. 4 marks. If you just calculate this over here, 4 plus 3, 7, 7 plus 3, 10. Already 10 marks out of 40, these 10 marks are yours. And this is it's in the marks in your pocket, but you have to work for it to gain this mark. You have to work hard, because these are the marks. If you go wrong, you will get straight away 0, my dear children. This is there is no options for over here. Then write short notes. Question number 2B, any 2 out of 3. Meaning, if you see, again 4 marks over here. With options, 6 marks are there. Question 2B, write short notes. Any 2 out of 3, again 4 marks. Question 3, we have explained the statements with reason. Any 2 out of 3, again 4 marks. With options, 8 marks. Read the question 4 will be read the extract and answer the question. 4 marks straight away over there. In that, you get a first 2 question, 1 mark. And the last question will be of 2 marks. And the last one will be answer the following questions in detail. Any 2, 4 marks. That is the history part, layout. Then we go to the question number 6 to 9. We have again the objectives for you. See, children, 2 marks. Choose the correct option and complete the statement, any 2 out of 2. So 10, this to 12. Then we have a true or false. Again, you have a state whether the following statements are true or false. 7, question number 7. Any 2 out of 3. So 14 marks. I would say 10, 12 to 14 marks is already here within your hands. Then question 8A, explain the concept. Any 1 out of 2, 2 marks. Question 8B, again, diagrams will come to you. Do as directed, instructed, any 1 out of 2. The objectives are there. Question 9, answer the following in brief. Any 1 out of 2, 12 marks. Total 40 marks. Now, if you see, my dear children, the board has framed such a way, the paper pattern, where you have options from question 2. You just see everywhere there are out of three. You have choices. You have ample of choices for preparing for yourself also, and you can solve the paper. If you thoroughly prepared yourself, you definitely, I don't think you will find the paper difficult. In fact, it will be very easy for you. And once you have read the textbook, it will be very, very easy for you. So I always stress that, read history textbook. So let's go further with the question wise now. The question 1. Okay, now question 1 itself is the question 1, sub question A and B is choose the correct option from given option and rewrite the statement. Now here, you are expected to know some of the important people names, their work, their achievement, the sports, the types of sport, historical sources, places. Now choose the correct option and rewrite the statement. Most of the time I have seen children are writing direct answer. Most of the time. It's wrong. They say, rewrite the statement. You write the entire statement, underline the statement. It carries 3 marks, 3 options. See, if you over here, I'll just show you an example. See, this is one. Dash is the mother of science and all other branches of knowledge. Okay, now write the entire statement and then underline the answer. Many a time children just write directly the answer. Don't write direct answer. Read the instruction, read the question. These are 3 marks are very vital. When you begin with the question paper to solve, this is the first question we'll be writing. And as I told you, that begin with question 1 till the question number 9 systematically. And the first answer, so Bilhar is known as a village of books. That's the answer over there. Paper we have come across, they write books. There is a statement. Statement is not there. So how do you expect one mark? The moderator and the exam will not give you marks because you have made your own mistakes. So avoid this. So don't do all this. These are all silly mistakes done by you. The examiners, moderators will not consider you. If you want 40 out of 40, avoid this silly mistake. This is your error. I would say this is done by you. Knowingly also you have to happen over here. So this is the first question which I told you that choose the correct option from the and complete the sentence. For this question, if you see your textbook, now already out of 9, 2 chapters are deleted. So it's 7. Every chapter, if you open and see, there are two correct options are given. So it comes to 14. So learn those thoroughly. And why did I ask you to read the textbook? Because the question that comes over here, the question which has been asked, I'll just show you one slide. See, art, sports, important people, their work, the names, everything. So when you read textbook, because within the textbook, the questions are framed. Don't be in a mindset, okay, I've run the backshell textual questions, so the paper, I'm prepared, the objectives. No. That's why I'm telling, read the textbook thoroughly so that you can, any question that's come from within the textbook, based on this correct option, objective questions, you can easily get the marks. Let's go further. This I told you. See, this is the answer. For example, like it may be said that Voltaire was the founder of modern historiography. Either you do a box or you underline. Philosophy is the mother of science and all other branches of knowledge. Do a box. So presentation, as I told you, presentation matters a lot in the board paper. It's a skill, it's an art. How do you want to get that full marks and a good percentage? Bilhar is known as the village of books. So this is how you do presentation. Very neat, very systematically when you do, the examiner also will be happy to correct your paper. Now, so that's the first part is clear. Then question number 1B. Students should be able to identify the wrong pair and rewrite. It may include topics like writer, books, scholar, work, persons, achievements, philosophy, etc. Now, this is a first 3 mark. This is a set where you have a 3 sets of 4 pairs. Each will be given. The wrong pair should be identified and write down. Students are not expected to correct it. Make a note, my dear children. When I have evaluated the paper, still students are correcting, writing the wrong pair. Don't do that. There is strictly notice there that you have to not to correct. Identify the wrong pair means only identify the wrong pair. 3 sets are there and 3 marks. One mark has to be written directly. Now, how to write? I always seen children, they don't write in a proper sequence. You just mentioned, number 1, this is the wrong pair, and which is the wrong pair. Just mention full 1 mark is given. I'll just show you one day. Move over here, see if it is. This one. Identify and write the wrong pair in the following: V.K. Javade, V.D. Savarkar, Pandit Ramabhai, Mahatma Phule. So, like this, 3 sets will be given to you. Suppose example is like Pandit Ramabhai. So you just mentioned point number 3, Pandit Ramabhai, Stree Purush Tulna. I'm just giving an example to you. Or the Kesari, Bal Gandhar Tilak. That's a right pair, in fact, I would say. So any 3, these 3 are your marks. You need to write correctly. Identify the wrong pair means wrong pair. Maximum papers which I have evaluated, my experience is, they write the wrong pair and down they write, this is the correct pair, and they correct the answers also. This, there will be no marks will be given to you. You are losing your own mark, and these all are objective. As I mentioned to you, the first 3 questions, 1A and 1B, all are objective question, which are your marks. See, identify the wrong pair in the following, rewrite, marks 3. Pandit Ramabhai, Stree Purush Tulna. 2, third point, Din Bandhu Gopalari Deshmukh. 3-1, Rock Cut Caves. Matera, Chikaldara, 1 mark for identifying the wrong pair. So if you mention this pattern, number 1 or third one, Pandit Ramabhai, Stree Purush Tulna, 1 mark. Din Bandhu Gopalari Deshmukh, 1 mark. Rocket Materans. Means first 3 marks are correct. Identify the wrong pairs. Choose the correct options. That one. 1B is also correct. Identify the wrong pair. So you have scored 6 marks. So easily you have clear with the, you begin with your with a very positive note. I got 6 marks. So for that, that's why I said, solve the, read the textbook and solve the specimen papers. Already, I think now it's a time in month of December, you get a lot of specimen papers. make your papers and you solve this maximum practice, definitely these marks are yours. Then we go to the next part. There's a screen which is just. Yeah. Question number 2A, do as directed. Students can score full marks in the question based on concept map. Prepare the concept map, complete the timeline, practice how to figure drawing fast. Because 2 hours you have. You cannot waste time in drawing and taking a lot of time in drawing. You should know that this is my... See, time management is also one of the art of writing the paper in the board. So that's why I said solve papers. So these diagrams, every chapter you have 1 or 2 diagrams are there. On a foolscape paper, as a practice, you can write down all the... Choose the correct options, rewrite the statement, identify the wrong pair, diagrams you can write, and ask your friends. At least the first question number 1A and 1-2 orally to take. You are prepared. Then as practice papers, many examples are that you write down with the answers. You can interact with your friends. Come on, let's take orally the activities. So you are preparing for your history paper automatically. And diagrams, every chapter, if you just turn your textbook page, every chapter ending, there are 2 diagrams are there. One is there. More practice papers, you'll get more diagram. Practice that. And this is full 2 marks. In this question, any 2 out of 3 activities, you have to do it, and half mark for each activity. Draw with pen and write with pen. Some of the papers we have come across, they draw with pencils and they write with also pencil. That's wrong. Pencil is considered not as an answer, my dear. Please make a note over here. 4 marks are yours. And suppose if you are not able to get the 4 options in the diagram, 3, every segment or every block, whatever, whether it's a timeline or whether it's a, what you call flowchart, half of mark is there. Don't skip questions. I don't never do kind of that. I don't know this diagram, so I'm skipping this. Don't do that. Whatever you know, whether you know the 2 points, write 2 points. Maybe 1 mark will be assigned for over there. So these are do as directed. So you can score full marks here also. Write, draw very bold, neatly with a good handwriting, and underline those particular areas. So examiner knows we have taken a lot of effort and your presentation is very good. I'll just show you one pattern. Another. See, complete the following concept chart map. This is, so when this diagram is given in this format, in the block method, you have to draw the block. Now it's so, see, every half of mark is given over here. Western Ghat, you write answer 1 half mark. So there are 4 over here. So this is where you should do. When there is a timeline, draw the timeline. When there is a tree diagram, draw the tree diagram. I mean, you have to draw. Sometimes we have seen children are not drawing only. Answers are correct, but they just write 1, 2, 3, 4 in series. That's not. Because this is a concept chart, map, drawing. So any 2 full marks, 4 marks are yours. So this precaution you must take when solving this particular question. See the other one, indoor games, types of tourism. So here, this is very easy, indoor games. If you have read the textbooks, whatever indoor games you write, the marks will be given. It is not that whatever answers we know, if the indoor games which are correct, which is already mentioned in textbook, if it is correct, we'll give you full marks, types of tourism. So means if it is coming in this type, the pattern, the drawing, same pattern you have to draw. Don't change the pattern of diagram also. Though the answers are correct, it will not be considered. When it is given this pattern, present. And see, the answers over here, see. Carom, chess, playing cards, games played with gamesmen. There are many more. So if you know more, then they are genuinely the indoor games, you will be getting a due credit marks. Automatically, you will be getting the credit over there. And many games, if you read the textbook, many indoor games are given over there. Tourism, geographical tourism, health tourism, agro-tourism, historical tourism, types of tourism. And you can even underline also geographical, historical, agro, health tourism. You can also underline that part. So this is the first 2 segments. So once you finish this and if it is correct, automatically you feel the flow of the paper will go. You will get, yes, now I'm well set up. Now I can go ahead with, because your answers are almost like 4 plus 2. You have already scored 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 marks. Out of 40 objectives, you have already got the correct mark. question to see. 2B answers now. Importance of sports. This is a right short notes now. Any two. Feminist history, importance of sports, archers. Now, for example, like importance of sports. Now, many children, they don't know how many points to be mentioned. You have to write at least 25 to 30 words in the right short notes. And remember, history paper, your presentation should be in a point wise. It has to be in a point wise. At least 6 points, 8 points has to be over there. Then you can mention some additional, for example, like importance of sports. Now, you know the names of the sports, some of the events you know. Mention that, some of the players' names you know. Underline that. Wherever you feel that I need to highlight this particular name, particular person name, particular event, particular date, particular historian's name, or particular archaeologist's name, anything, just underline. This is called that you are thoroughly well prepared, and the examiner and the monitor knows this is the highlighted points. So any 2-4 marks, 25 to 30 words should be your presentation, neat and systematically, definitely you will get them. Feminist history. There are so many feminine names are there in the history textbook. If you know any others, if you know the references also, you can present, because as I said, it's application-based knowledge. Your curriculum is based on your thinking, knowledgeable skills, application. And when you meet as a moderator, when we see the child is writing something, a reference number, references is given, he's giving that reference, that it's very nice to when you collect such papers. So you can go ahead with this part. See, one answer I've given over here. See, 1, 2, 3 points. So games are important place in our life. It helps us to overcome pains, worries, suffering. Games help us to relax and refresh our mind. Now, this is my point of view of importance of sport. But what is your way of expressing the importance of sport? You write down. Definitely, if it is correct, sensible to the question, relevant marks you will get by the examiner and the moderator also. Any 2 points, 2 marks over there. See, point-wise, everything is point-wise. Your entire paper or presentation is in a systematic point-wise. So that's, you should know that I have to write the paper. So when you're practicing for your prelims and upcoming examination, see that you present your paper in a point-wise. Learn that skill of writing 1 point, 2 points, 4 points, and giving examples out of the way, which is maybe like it is a relevant example. You can just express. That will be very, you know, an extra edge for your marks over here. That is one of the things. That's why I said read textbook, other references, that will definitely help you to score good marks. This is one answer I've just mentioned over there. See, then we come to question 3. Explain the given statements with reasons. Now, this is give reasons. Students are expected to give reasons for any 2 out of 4. So again, you have 4 choices. Out of 4, any 2 you have to present. Appropriate points you should be given over there. 1 mark for each reason. Now, here also, many a time children ask, sir, how much should be the content? How many points should be over there? You just write 20 words. 15 words. See, nobody's going to count the words. The experience, the examiners, moderators, or the teachers have, they know that the answer is correct. The judgment they have. And if it is relevant points are there, it's the 4 points and all of that. So you automatically 2 marks will be assigned. 1 mark for each reason. This is the one question, like, for example, like, Voltaire is said to be the founder of modern historiography. The list of World Heritage Sites is announced by UNESCO. These are the questions, my dear. Archives and libraries publish research journalists, informative pamphlets, leaflets, etc. 6 January is observed as the Patrakar Din in Maharashtra. Now, children, it's not like that entire paper, all textual questions are always asked in the give reasons, brief answers, right? Short. No. Because when you go through the textbook, there are do you know, boxes are there. Can you tell? Do you know? Many, every chapter, this kind of activities are given for you. Do you know? So maybe they may pick up from there. That's why I say, from the starting only, I said, read textbook. Because you cannot say, sir, from where this question has come. It is not then behind the textbook. No. It may be from can you tell us? Do you know? I mean, if you just turn any pages, like if you turn in a history, any textbook page, chapter, always there are, you know, interesting to know facts for you. I mean, I would say, do you know? That is the area most of the children don't read. Do you know? In fact, your objective questions, maybe your unseen passages, I would say the passage which is there, they pick up from there only. So read that particular part. Now, see, why he's called said to be the founder of modern historiography. Now, because he is umpired that he is a historiography, the focus should not be only on objective. Further archaeology of historical events, it was an important to consider social tradition, pre-economic, agriculture, etc. Now, if you are not beginning with the etc., you can just write the statement once again. So the Voltaire is said to be the founder of modern historiography. That's the correct way. So when you end, always try to end with the question statement. Means, like for example, it was an important to consider social, tradition, trade, economic, agriculture, etc. Next line you just write down, so the Voltaire is said to be the founder of modern historiography. This is a method. This is, you should know, therefore I have to write the closing statement has to be mentioned from the question which is given over there. This is one example, 2 points, 2 marks. So he gave a rise to thought that understanding all aspects of human life is important for issue. So any 2 points, 1 mark for each point. So full 2 marks are yours. Now it is also been seen some of the, that you can underline important point over here also. It's not necessary that only fill in the blanks or choose the option or maybe like some of the diagrams you can underline. You can even just fill, like for example, like this question, I want to underline the word, for example, social traditions. I want to underline the word chronology of historical event. You can underline that. Underline with the same pen or pencil. You can just underline over there and you can, it feels better. It's always good. See, importance of life. That's the question number. We have covered, we have just finished with the question 3, that is right short note, question 4. Now, this is a comprehension passage. Many a time, this has been added for you for the 9th and 10th standard, what is comprehension passage? A small passage will be given, 12 to 15 lines will be given to you. You have to read those passages because though the 4 marks it is there, 1 mark each for 2 marks will be one mark and the last question will be an open-ended question will be asked for you so that we can see your test your understanding and your application. Now, from where the passage is taken? They can take from any chapter of your textbook. Can you tell? Maybe you're like, Bharat Ke Khoj. Then you have a radio, television is there, chapter, tourism chapter is there. Any concept. They may just take it 10 to 12 lines to read it. So for this, you need a time. So when you plan out your paper solving, history paper, see that you plan your timings also. How much time you require for question number 1, question 2, question 3. So there are 9 questions. So your time factor is also important because here it takes time. We cannot just copy the passages point to point. Learn to write the answers in your own words. In your own words. Try your level best that I can just frame my answer and I can conclude with a very good. That is the part. You just take copy with the brackets. This is the answer. No, don't do that. Read, understand the passage, and then you just frame in your own word. Definitely, you will get full 1 mark. And the last question is an open-ended question. Write 3 sentences or 4 sentences. Definitely, you will get a 1.5 mark. It is full right. Full 2 marks is also given over here. In fact, many a time, like, Bharat Ke Khoj passage has been asked, which was, and many questions are based on the radio. There's one passage, one container on radio. Technology is there, industries and commerce is there. So there, anywhere. That's why I said you cannot just depend on from where it has taken. It is from your textbook. So just go through it. Again, it is scoring. But for that, you need to read the textbook once again. See. So this may come, the entire passage. Read the given passage and answer the question given below. The question might be like, for example, like, it is based on what? A book written by Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. It's a series of presentation of history of India, what is described over there, the social, the culture, there is a period of great Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj history has been described, Mughal history has been described, then various movements, samajes, the role of Mahatma Gandhi, the role of Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar, everything. Then the questions can. So for this, you need a time. So in the 2 hours, how much time do you require to cover up this question? Then don't write direct answers. One word. For example, the question is the writer of the book. Which book is taken from? Jawaharlal Nehru. Don't do that mistake. It is written, the book, the discovery, it is based on the discovery of India written by Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. Complete full sentence. The moment you do all the shortcut method, in fact, it is called reducing your marks. Don't do that. When you are knowing that, I can write, I know the answers, follow the instructions which is there. Definitely the 1 mark, 2 marks, the last question, 2 marks are there. It's an open-end question. Many times children I have seen, they don't write open-end questions because they're not able to understand, or maybe they don't know what to present. It is an application base. I mean, I have this is what passage. See. Yeah, read the given passage. This I just cover up. Third question carries 2 marks. This is a passage. Yeah. Now answer in detail the fifth question. Now, this is where you need to write in detail, my dear children. You need to present in a very good way. And it can come into, like in a table format, observe the picture. So it's like, a detailed preparation has to be there. Now it carries 6 marks. So it may be like, you have to write either this 8 points or 6 points. So go through one of the part over I just mentioned, go through all the pictures given in textbook and study them, because this is a answer in detail. It's a very, very important to understand the pictures. Many pictures are there. A picture of Olympic rings, a picture of maybe of a museum. Kolkata Museum is given to you. So if you don't know the history behind that, how you will write the answer? So that is why it's over there. Like for example, like clay tablets. So the picture is given to you. And then if you don't know, you will say, well, what is the history of this? I don't know. In the first chapter itself, when I was just going through it, like, the Indian Museum, Kolkata. So picture is given to you. Now you cannot write in there any other history in there. History is nothing like, it has to be very fact. It has to be genuine. The dates, the event, the person's name. So whatever pictures, and if you see your textbook is full of pictures, can you tell there are many events are there? So Sagarwan copper plates picture is there. Then you have a plateaus pictures are there. So many, many pictures are there, in fact. And so go through all the pictures and read what is the behind. There is a picture of Mona Lisa. So that history, you should know the Mona Lisa's picture. What is that? So you cannot just say it's a picture of Mona Lisa. No. But what is it? It is carrying a vital, in detail information. So that is very, very important. That's why I was stressing to you that read the textbook very thoroughly. See, you are required to answer 2 questions out of 4 questions. Answers must be written point-wise and adequate length. Okay. Now, length means it has to be in detail, almost like 8 points, 6 points. It contains in a very detailed analysis. You can underline here also the main points. Highlight them in 6 small points or 3 points. So if you write 6 points, well and good. Very nice. If you don't want to make it into detail into 2 parts, go into 3 points. Detail. There's a small spelling mistake over there. It should be a detail over there. So this is where you need to prepare. You have to learn answers very thoroughly, because these are the area where you need a time to write also. With a good handwriting should be there. The flow of handwriting should not change, because start to end your handwriting has to be very, very good. So usually happen that you don't have when you have a less time, you try to increase your speed, the handwriting changes. And you make grammatical mistakes. Sometimes it's not able to understand to the examiner and the moderator, you may lose your marks. So you need a proper flow of your handwriting also, very neat. And it takes time. This question number 5 takes time. That's why I say time management. Learn the concept of which question requires how much time. So the time management depends on every child different way. Some may able to finish right very beforehand 10 minutes. They may able to cover up. Some may take more time. And it has its own way of writing the paper. But it's the practice. The more you solve the papers, practice papers, you will get that judgment. Baba, I need a question number 5 more time. Question number 4, I need less time. Whatever, vice versa. So this individual variations, differences are always there. Okay, we go to the next one now. I hope you are understanding, my dear children, as I am going. See, these are the few questions. What is Max's history? What kind of training is required to study written sources? What were different means of communication known around the world before the advent of newspaper? Differences between local tourism and international tourism. So these are all these are detailed analysis questions. maybe 6 points. If you write more points, very good. More points also very good. It will be evaluated. It's not that only 6 points, only stick to it. You can write more points. And if you can, then as I said, around the what are the different means of communication, you can give many examples in that. As I said, you can highlight the examples. Wherever you feel this is relevant example, it is applicable. It is very good. Because as I said to you that your paper is based on entire, it's called as an activity sheet. It's an application based and understanding your skills, knowledge. So more you present with that kind of way, it is always going to add an edge to you. We'll just see one of the answers I'll just try to show to you. See, 6 points. The knowledge of scripts like Brahmani, Modi, the first, second question answer I'm given is basic knowledge of social organization, traditions, knowledge of now various schools, styles of paintings, knowledge of type, history of the development, knowledge of types of papering, colors, wherever you feel relevant, under the museum galleries, for example. You can give a names of museum galleries also over there. You can, if you know what this is, there are museums, I know the names of museum, just write down the museum's name. So scripts like Bahamani script, Modi, underline those things. So that is styles of painting, sculpture. They give an examples of paintings. Definitely it will be appreciated over there. The research reports, there are articles. It is there in your textbook. If you see there are various names also, you can just try to give, okay, these are the reports presented by so-and-so in this particular chapter. It's very good. So you get automatically an edge of getting a good full marks over here also. It's not that in history you cannot get full marks. You can score 40 out of 40. Remember that. Okay, so we have just covered up in this 15 to 20 minutes, whatever, the first segment of the history part. I hope you are able to get it, what I mean to say. Okay, the last 10 minutes, I will just stop to clear your doubts, your question answers. I can just solve your doubts, queries over here. So come to the question number 6 now. This is a multiple choice question, once again. So here, 4 questions will be given for you for each statement. Rewrite the statement with the selected correct alternative. Underline the selected option, 1 mark for each statement, total 2 marks. So again, objective has come to you. You have if you see the political chapter, one chapter has been deleted as per the government, the reduced portion, the last one. Hardly there are few chapters left in your hand. Read those chapters thoroughly and whatever the backside questions are, go through it. Means maybe you may, 1 or 2 might come, the full 2 marks are yours if it is correct. Underline the options over there. So, mean practically, if you see, it is the way you prepare with the maximum practicing skills. Question, make a full scale, as I told you at the beginning also. Write down all the political science, multiple choice question. Ask your friends or ask to anybody. Just take orally. Prepare yourself. See, your preparation begins in this month itself for your upcoming board examination and prelim examination. And tell them, okay, let's take verbally this kind of activity. And once that particular practice question sets on your hand, you will get ample of multiple choice questions, as we say in MCQ questions. And definitely, it may be that you will get 1 or 2 correct, you will get full marks over there. Say, I'll give you one example is over here. Yeah, choose the correct option from the given option and complete the statement 2 marks. 2 statements will be given and you have to attempt both. Each statement carries 1 mark over here. So again, the mistakes which are happening is that children write direct answers. Sometimes they write 2 answers, options they write. That's wrong. When they say you are out of the 3 bracket answers, 3, don't write 3 or 2, only 1. I don't practically understand why. The examiners will not consider, oh, yeah, wrong. So this first one is wrong, the second one is correct, consider. No. Write 1 answer which is thoroughly well prepared by you. Be confident that no, this answer option is correct and my spelling is also correct. Or spelling has to be correct because it is in the question paper. And underline that very nicely. Leave 1 line and go for second question. See, leave a line. Every question you have to read. And as that we all know, that every question you have to go to attempt into a new paper, a new new page. Sub question can do in the same page over there, but a new paper, a new page, a new question. So this and basic mistakes As I told you, some people they write direct answers. Some people they write all the three options. Have you come across? Sometimes they write both options. Maybe if the first one is wrong, second one is will be considered. So this is not acceptable because you are giving not any other. It's a board paper. You are going to give a paper to go to will be evaluated by an outsider, not by your history teacher also. So it is there is a format of evaluating. The paper will be created in some systematic pattern. There is a certain rules are there to evaluate a paper. There is a kind of an, you know, you have to follow the criteria. So if you are not in that criteria, this objective 2 marks you lose this because it is just an objective. And as I told you, out of 40 marks, your 12 to 14 marks are this. One of the question is this. And if you are not getting this right, you lose your mark. So don't do that silly errors. Yeah. See, as I told you, underline the selected option. This is very important. Underline. Okay. State whether the following statements are true or false. Now, true or false, basic thing is that it carries 2 marks. But when students have to explain any 2 statements with reason out of 3, again, you have a 3 is there. But what mistakes we come across? First, I'll just write this read part. First, identify and rewrite whether the statement is true or false. Identify it very nicely, my dear. Many times it happens that children don't identify only the statement. They go wrong. Identify. So write down, the above statement is true. We make a note of that. You have to begin the question, answer like this. The above statement is true or maybe or false. Underline that. But what we come across sometimes, children write T-R-U-E. Sometimes they write F-A-L-E-S-E, false. Sometimes they just put T. They put F. Or they put both, true also, oblique false. Now, this is not the pattern. So state whether the following statements are true or false. You need to write the above statement is true, underline that, and give the reason. You have to give the reason why the statement is true and false, and then conclude that particular statement. So the statement is so and so. That is also very important that you have to conclude, even in the, I told you, in the give reasons and all. Make a statement with the conclusion. That has to be there. Conclude that. But, and this is, see, when you identify, you get half mark. See, in brief, give the reasons in brief, my dear. Don't just write one small reason. 2 sentences, 3 sentences. Identifying half mark, 1 mark, then 1 mark will be given for your reasons over there. And overall, it carries 2 marks over here. This means it is your 1 mark. It's just your 1 mark. But children write, if they do, they are not prepared. Either they write 2 answers, they write T, they write F, they write, don't write above statement is true or false. So how do you expect an examiner or a moderator to give you this marks, which is yours? And if you read your, if you see, there are only few true or false in every chapters. Additional practice you have to do from the specimen papers, which you're going to get it. But maybe, as I told you, when you read, the questions can come in the board from within the textbook. So read the textbook. Here also, there are many statements from political science. If you read the chapters, there are many statements which are can be considered for true or false. That is very, very important, my dear children. So this mistakes I have, at least I have come across in my, this as a moderatorship, the children are not serious about this question. So don't do that particular thing. See, I just... Okay. Explain whether the following statements are true or false. Now, see, one example is given to you. Give reason. Indian democracy is considered the largest democracy in the world. Okay. And give reasons. Okay. Political parties act as a link between the government and the people. Movement do not need a strong leadership. Now, sir, there are some children, they write the question, then they solve the answer. That is also okay. No problem. If they are very comfortable with the time of 2 hours, they can complete the entire paper. That is, it's real good. Now, this answers, see how to be written. See, I'll just, I think it's not there. Yeah, see, the given statement is true. This is very important. Or you write the above statement is true or false. This is has to be there. Children, what they do, they you people write true, false. As I mentioned just now, and see the points. The political parties conveys the demands and complaints of the people to the government. The government tries to get set up of the people for its policies and programs to the political party. Then you come, even if you mention, so the question what is given to you, just complete that. Will do. But this is a pattern. Two reasons. See, two points are mentioned for the reason. Your reason has to be in brief. If you don't write the reason, you lose your marks. If you don't write the true or false, which is you are not able to identify also, it's gone. You lose your mark. So we have to identify that. Otherwise, there is no one mark will be given for you and one mark for the reason. Okay, this is one. Eighth question now. Okay, now see, again, as I mentioned to you, explain the following concept, which is that two concepts will be given in sub question. You are expected to answer. There are diagrams. Again, you have a diagrams over here. If you see chapter wise, again draw a new page with a good handwriting. Whatever, whether it's a tree diagram, whether it's a flow diagram, whether it's a map, maybe it's a any kind of a timeline is given to you based on the political chapters which we have. So draw with pen. Maximum time, children are drawing with pencil and they write with pencil. I repeat, the board has specified that you can draw with pen. It will be evaluated. It will be checked. There will be no problem. You will not lose your marks, my dear children. And see that when you write the points, it is absolutely correct. So that every 4 points, whatever you mention, it will be correct over here. I think that's question 9. And I'm just sorry. That's question 8-1. This is a part which is a 25 to 30 words question. Concept, right? Short note concept. I just skip on mine. Two concepts will be given, and you are expected to answer anyone. Now this is like a form of a right short. Like for example, so like right to information. So there are 6 points are there. 3 points. Which year the right to information was enacted? Mention that the purpose of right for information. So this. Every answer should have at least 4 points. Every answers. 25 to 30 words, as I said, you write over there, full 2 marks will be given. As I told you, if your points are correct, if there are 4 points, they are genuinely correct points, definitely you are going to score full marks in history paper. If everything is point-wise, systematically, no cancellation, everything, the marks will be allotted to you. And as I said, it is not that whatever the solution says to us, whatever the answers which we know and which we have is, and your answers are some is written by your own way, but it is applied is correct. It is sensible to the question, relevant to the topic. It is sensible. It will be given due credit. Remember this. That's why the paper is, the curriculum is framed such a way where children is given an opportunity to express their views. So write short notes. Is an area where you can easily score your marks very comfortably. And you can underline wherever you feel, no, I want to underline this, highlight this particular part. I want to highlight it, underline that. There is no harm. Wherever you find it's relevant, try to underline that part. See, right to information regionalism. This is one answer. Government of India gave the right to information to. Now, I have not mentioned the year. But if you know the year when the right to information was implemented, it's well and good. It's an additional. It's always a good. So yes, this is the answer over here. Right to information has made the government more transparency, has reduced that. So you can underline the word transparency, accountability. So this technique, there's this technique of writing paper has reduced the element of secrecy in the working of the government. Explain the following concept. Anyone, it's and now you will be, it's a, 2 marks will be given to you over there. See, continue with the same question. It is necessary to create opportunities for citizens' participation, interaction with government. Increasing communication between the citizens and government helps in strengthening democracy and in building up a relationship of trust between them. So overall, there are 4 points. See, one, two, three, four. 2 points, 1 mark for each point is given to you. And it's not so difficult. If you are framing in your own words also the answers, see to it that it is correct. And as this is the way you can do 4 points. Then this was which the part which I told you previously before we come to this question, diagrams. This is again, so when it is whatever the diagram is projected to you in the question paper, same way you have to draw. If it is in this pattern, go for this pattern. If it is in the timeline, four diagram, tree diagram, you have to copy as it is. Don't modify in your own way or your own style. Now, national parties in India. Now, you know, Bharatiya Janata Party, Congress Party, they are national parties, okay? But many times we have come across children, they mix regional parties. Maharashtra, we have, you can see as a regional party. So don't write both the options, national and regional parties. There are many questions. I have taken this one question. If you just turn your political science chapters on this particular chapter, there are a list of what you call the national parties and the regional parties. So read thoroughly. Don't get confused. When you are confused, you are all those diagram questions will go wrong. That's why I said practice those diagrams. You should know. Then many children, what they do, as I told you, the mistakes, they don't draw. As I told you in the first part also, they write directly number one in National Congress Party, Bharatiya Janata Party, Congress, Trinamool Congress Party, 1, 2, 3. How do you expect to get the marks? These are 2 marks are very vital. Half of mark for each answers are given over here. So don't do this kind of a error, I would, error which you are responsible for losing your 2 marks. Yeah, see. Indian National Congress, National Congress Party, Bharatiya Janata Party, Bahujan Samaj Party. These are the national parties in India. But suppose you are writing regional or writing other countries' parties over there, how do you expect? So you know to learn. That's why read those chapters, which are the party, don't mix up. Never mix up with all those confusion. Or make a list of in notebook. This is the national party, this is the regional parties. Many things you can note it down. See, in your note, wherever you make one specimen notebook, like as I told you, make a list of the prehistoric newspapers, authors, archaeologists, historians' name, after the independence, what is happening, what were all those names, if you make the movements took place, whatever. This will give you a key to your preparation when you make a list of all those things, because your questions of the objectives are in that way, the MCQ pattern, like you say. I mean, you can easily come to know. So the writers, the newspaper, and the editors' names, the kind of the activities, the movement. So where if you just write the key, these are the key before the independence, after the independence, the types of tourism, as I told you. So these are the indoor game, then the outdoor game, many lists you make. Automatically you will be able to, it's like, you know, preparing for your objective question. The feminist historiography, who are those? Museums, there's so many museums in your textbooks, names are there. So make a list and keep. So this will definitely help you to memorize, and you will recollect. Then ask, and you can, as I told you, you can just ask somebody, come on, just take, let's have a history activity orally. So these sessions, you can when a teacher is not there, there's a proxy period is there. Ask someone, come on, let's go for a MCQ question. Let's go for an objective. Let's go for a diagram. And ask, and what you should do, come on, 2 minutes, 5 minutes. So these skills, which is when you do, you are practicing, you are learning, and you will be get full marks, because as I told you, objectives, the marks are not deducted. If it is very nicely drawn, very systematically on a nice new page with a very beautifully full 4 marks, full 2 marks is assigned to you by the examiner and the moderator. This is one example. And this is one example I give you. Then we have answer in brief anyone. The last this is a political science question. Again, you have any one, 2 options. Again, the 2 options, again, the options are there for you. Half mark for each point. But many a time I come across, by the time children reach to the question number 8 and 9, the handwriting changes. Sometimes the paper is incomplete. They are not solved. Sometimes the answer in brief it is. It's not hardly 1 sentence or 2 sentences. That means short of time. Or maybe you don't know the answers. You're running short of time because you have the time is maybe diverted or wasted somewhere in other irrelevant other questions. So as I told you, time management. Papers are incomplete. Never do those things. Avoid such things. Complete your paper 10 minutes before, because even this question carries a 2 vital mark. Again, this is in brief. So you need to write, a question like, what is code of conduct? Explain. So you have to write the meaning, maybe a definition or some of the things, point for which reform were women in the pre-independence period fighting. Give in detail. anyone. See, it has to be 6 points, 25 to 30 words. But children who write detail, who are very systematic, they crosses, I told you, 38 and above, 40 also. But many times children are not able to complete only the answer. They miss, they come to 7, 8, and the remaining part, they just wind up. Otherwise, the handwriting drops. It becomes very shabby, we can't read. And even if it is correct, we are not able to understand, and then it's a loss of yours. So don't do such thing. That's why I said, end your paper at least 10 minutes prior so that you can go through your entire paper from question number 1 to question number 9. Check your every answer, especially the objectives, and wherever you can, that I have to underline that, and see whether the question numbers are correct. Because many a time, sometimes the children write in a hurry, or maybe like pressure, maybe because of the overconfidence, or some reasons the question numbers are given wrong. So it's very difficult. You lose your mark. Maybe it's a bad luck of yours. So it means it's not correct. You're writing a true or false. True or false, if you see over here, my dear children, it's like, for example, do as directed. It's a right short note. You're writing question number 9. How do you expect examiner to go through it? So it's a wrong impression. Either no full marks, or maybe the marks will reduce. So avoid such carelessness. See, answer in brief. Anyone? See, the answer is over here. Second one. Eliminating injustice against women, to put an end to the exploitation of women, to help them to lead a respectful and dignified life, to end the practice like sati, child marriage. Now you can underline these words. Respectful, dignified life, sati, child marriages, you can underline. Widow remarriages, right to vote to women, were responsible. Any 2 points, 1 mark for each point. So this is the pattern. In a history paper, as I told you, this is a pattern. You can just go ahead and complete the paper. I mean, every entire paper is based on your point-wise presentation over there. Point-wise. Just see to it that you are writing in a point-wise the answers over there. Okay? So this is one of the part. Then the mistakes we have come across, like some of the children, they just, the handwriting is the use of the ink pen. They write with so light pen that it's very difficult to read. The answers we can't read. So what you must do, my dear children, in a compass box, keep at least 3 to 4 pens ready, or use it, make it dark, and then write. Don't write with a faint handwriting and all. This is a wrong impression. Creates a bad impression. Creates a bad impression. Even if it's difficult to, means the answers will not able to read by the examiners and moderator, your marks will be deducted, and it becomes unnecessary, all those things. We have come across such kind of papers like this over there. So just recapitulate, we will go one before as I told you, so we will give 5-10 minutes to for your doubt to be clear over there. I hope you are able to understand what I am saying, my dear children, and who are part of this session. See, this is the layout of your paper. And if you see, as I told you, the objectives are in your hands. In short, I will just try to, I have a time in hand. So just see, this is the first 1A, 1B. Take a full scope paper. I repeat once again, read the textbook, specimen papers, you may get it now. Write down all the objectives, correct options, identify on a full scope paper, diagram, and draw. Make one folder file. And once it is ready, it will take time for you, no doubt. 1 day maybe, at the most 1 day. Hardly you have 7 chapters, 2 chapters are deleted. And ask, and then just go on reading, by heart it. Answer should be by heart. Don't just read. See whether you do by heart. And then ask your friends to take it, or you yourself write. So these 6 marks, as I told you, yours. Then another part which I want to do is that this one. Again, you have a political science. Again, 2 marks, objectives are there. Diagrams, as I told you, do as directives over there, true or false. These areas are yours. In fact, you should not lose your marks. This is the area where you can easily get those magic number of 14. Many times some children say, sir, out of 40, what is passing? So don't think the 14 is the passing. We wish that you should score 40 out of 40. Think about high and how I can get maximum marks. But really, if you are finding it is too difficult, these areas, you should focus. Baba, this is the area where I can at least gain the mark. Some children might not be able to by heart the big answers, answer briefly. So for them, I would say by heart and write. write three four times, then after, as the practical basic ways, what practice papers are coming now, solve the paper. If you don't know the answer, keep it blank. Afterwards, after solving, after 2 hours, just go through it, then again by heart it. Definitely you will get it. Max 3 papers or 4 papers you must solve on your own, so that you will get that confidence that you have prepared for your upcoming examination. But if you are just turning the pages of textbooks, you are not reading, you are reading it for a namesake, you are not able to understand it, then it's no use. It's no use. The paper, as I told you, maximum questions are coming from within the textbook. And they, as I told you, like questions like, I just turned one of, like, can you tell me? So every lesson there is this, do you know? And every lesson it is there. Like, means it is there. You have to read those things. Do you know? Can you tell us? So I'll show you one, like, over here. Now see this textbook. Do you know this? Now images. Now for example, like images, I'll tell you, like, for example, like the first image itself. This one. On chapter 1, suppose this image is given to you, my dear children, and they will say an answer briefly. Look at the image and write the answer in detail. Unless you won't read this, how you will write? So you lose your 3 marks. So this is very important. So there are many images. I am not showing you now all the images, but if you see every pages, every chapter, there are images. Every chapter. Now this is another one. See, over here, this image. So if you have not scrolled your textbook, you have not opened your textbook, only what you will write in that question called answer the following in brief. As I'll just mean, it is a question number answer the following in sixth one over here. Question number 5. This one. Yeah. Answer the following. Any 2 out of 6 marks. I mean, this is where you lose your marks. And definitely it comes. It is not there. Now, for example, like, see, Gondeshwar temple. It comes in the paper. Don't take it for granted that all questions come from backside. No way. It is come from within. So that's why I said, emphasizes are given to read textbook. It's an activity-based paper. The entire worksheet is called as a worksheet. You have to know everything. Minute things you have to know. So read the textbook. Underline, this is important, maybe the name of a person, the dates, the events, particular similarities are given to you, various types of games, I told you, the indoor, outdoor game. Then we have question on tangible, intangible, the entire list is there for you. Then all these things are very important. One question which was, I always find children do a blunder mistake, that is, for example, like, yeah, even this one, Calcutta Museum. This museum picture is given. Children, they don't know which museum, they write any museum name. Calcutta, right? Sometimes they write Mumbai, they write England, they write France. How do you expect? You're going the wrong things. So read, that is one of the part. Tangible, intangible, make a list. What are the tangible? What are the various types of encyclopedias? What are buckers? So this one more, this small things, if you make a key notes, definitely will help you to prepare for your upcoming examinations over there. And max 3 to 4 papers you must solve on your own. Give to your co-teachers, subject teachers. Check it up. Please check them. And if you're and then you will get your own analysis that my performance is increasing. Where I'm going wrong? Which question is my weak? Which area I have to focus? Automatically, you should be able to judge. And the teachers are definitely are very good. They will definitely guide you. That about you, this area you need to score mark. But your efforts, your hard work, your personal dedication toward the subject, and reading and understanding the history textbook, and it's what is the concept, definitely it will not find very difficult paper for you. And so that is one of the method to write. And a complete paper, my dear children. Write complete paper from question 1 to question 9. Don't jumble the question 1, then question 5, then question 2. This is not way of writing the good presentation. It's not fair. It's irritating the examiner and monitor also. So every subject, I would say, presentation matters a lot. So go from start to end very nicely, underline wherever you feel. And if you don't know the answer, never mind, keep a space of time, keep the blank, continue with the next questions. By the time you automatically you will recollect the answers for that. Definitely you will get it up. If you are prepared, the brain you will recollect, memorize, you will be able to write down the answer over there, definitely. And in case when I am saying 6 points, 8 points, it doesn't mean that if you are not able to write on that moment, that day, 3 points you write down. Incomplete, never mind. Maybe the examiner will not give you full marks, but at least 1.5 marks, 2 marks. That's more important. Don't skip any question. Whatever you finish, as per your understanding, for example, like television, applied history, write short note on applied history, write short note on tourism. So just think yourself, before submitting your paper to supervisor, check everything, your date, the seat number, your, what you call, entire thing. Tie your supplement very nicely, go through your entire, see whether your all the things are properly written, question numbers are correct, and then submit. And with the positive frame of this hard work preparation, definitely you will score a very, very good marks, I would say. So I think I'll just end with this. If any doubt, we can have doubts can be clear of students then. So I just stop it for 10 minutes and I can ask the students, they can ask me questions. Yes, ma'am. Shall I, madam?
Yes. Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Your lecture was very informative. Now we move on to the next segment, that is question answer session. So students, you may raise your hand. You can ask your question.
Yes, Sachin is there. Yes, Sachin is raising a hand. Yes, Sachin.
Harshala, ma'am, please unmute them.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening, my dear. God bless you. Yes, tell me.
Sir, मुझे ये क्वेश्चन पूछना था, दो कंप्लीट द कॉन्सेप्ट मैप होता है, उसमें जो भी वेब डायग्राम या टेबल डायग्राम जो भी होते हैं, उसे पेन से बनाना है कि पेंसिल से?
एक्चुअली अगर आपने पेन से बनाया तो बहुत अच्छा रहेगा. ओके, पेन से बनाओ. पेंसिल से बनाया, लेकिन बनाया तो उसके जो आंसर है उसको आप पेन से लिखना. लेकिन
ओके,
हाँ, क्योंकि मेरे पास जो पेपर आते चेक करने के लिए, मोस्टली बच्चे क्या करते हैं, वो घाई घाई में और मुझे वो भूल जाते हैं कि वो क्या करते, पेंसिल से ड्रॉ कर देते हैं, लेकिन आंसर्स पेंसिल से लिखते, तो वहां पे आपको मार्क्स नहीं मिलेंगे. आप पेन से लिखो आंसर्स तो मार्क्स मिल जाएंगे आपको. यू विल गेट द मार्क्स. ओके
ओके. एंड
और बोर्ड ने वैसे भी कहा है कि यू कैन ड्रॉ विद द पेन. पेन से ड्रॉ करोगे तो वेल एंड गुड, नो प्रॉब्लम.
ओके सर. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन ये है, जैसे एनी 3 दिया रहता है,
हां,
अगर एनी 2 है और 3 क्वेश्चंस है,
हां,
तो मैंने अगर 3 लिखा,
हाँ,
तो जो पहले 2 में है मेरे को थर्ड से कम मिले, मींस फर्स्ट में मेरे को अगर 2 में से हाफ मार्क्स मिले, सेकंड में 1 मार्क्स मिले और थर्ड में 2 out of 2 मिले, तो पहले 2 को कंसीडर किया जाएगा कि जिसमें ज्यादा मिले वो 2?
जिसमें ज्यादा मिले वो. ओके, ऐसा है. जो मैक्सिमम मार्क्स जहाँ पे ज्यादा है, आपने अच्छा लिखा है, वो एग्जामिनर कंसीडर करता है. आप एक्स्ट्रा क्वेश्चन सॉल्व भी कर सकते हैं हिस्ट्री पेपर में. ओके, लेकिन ये देखना, ध्यान में रखना, जब हिस्ट्री पेपर सॉल्व करेंगे एक्स्ट्रा क्वेश्चंस, आप पूरा पेपर सॉल्व करना, लेकिन आपको टाइम मैनेजमेंट आना चाहिए कि हाँ मैं पूरा पेपर सॉल्व करूंगा, जिसमें मैं एडिशनल क्वेश्चंस भी मैं सॉल्व कर पाऊंगा, ये आपको ध्यान में रखना है. ओके, क्योंकि ऐसा ना हो जाए कि आप एडिशनल सॉल्व करते जाएंगे इस ऑप्शन में सॉल्व, लाइक फॉर एग्जांपल जो पैटर्न ने दिखाया आपको, तो पैटर्न मालूम है, लेआउट मालूम है. ऐसा नहीं होना चाहिए कि अभी हर क्वेश्चन में options any 2 out of 3, any 2 out of 3, any 2 out of 4, आप सभी solve करेंगे तो उतना time भी चाहिए अपने पास. अगर आप करते हैं, आपकी speed अच्छी है, handwriting अच्छा है, go ahead, लेकिन जिसमें ज्यादा marks है उसको हम consider करते हैं board में.
Okay. और sir, जो भी question answers होते हैं, जैसे answer the following question in detail, तो ज्यादा से ज्यादा हम उसमें जब लिखते हैं तो पॉइंट में लिखना चाहिए कि पैराग्राफ में ज्यादा बेहतर है.
ओके, अभी मैक्सिमम जो हमने जो मैं ट्रेस किया जो वर्ड्स, जैसे यानी पॉइंट्स में लिखो, ऐसा भी होता है कुछ बच्चों को नहीं जमता है पॉइंट्स में लिखना. अगर पैराग्राफ में लिखा और जो पॉइंट्स उसने जो कवर किया है, जो क्वेश्चंस के उसके बेस पे उसके जो पैराग्राफ लिखा है सही है, तो मार्क्स दिया जाता है बोर्ड में. ऐसा रॉन्ग कंसिडर नहीं किया जाता, इट जो मार्क्स विल बी गिवन टू यू, क्योंकि कुछ बच्चों को हैबिट नहीं रहती पॉइंट्स वाइज, डायरेक्टली पैराग्राफ में लिखते हैं. अगर सही है तो मार्क्स मिलता है.
मतलब ज्यादा बेहतर क्या होता है पॉइंट्स में ज्यादा?
आई प्रीफर, मेरे हिसाब से पॉइंट्स से लिखना अच्छा है, बेटर पॉइंट्स.
ओके सर.
अभी जब अभी प्रैक्टिस पेपर करे आ चुके हैं, अब आप सॉल्व करेंगे ना, तो कोशिश करो कि मैं कैसे वो पॉइंट्स में लिखूं, 6 पॉइंट लिखना है ये आंसर को, 2 पॉइंट में लिखना है ये आंसर को, ट्राई करो. क्योंकि उसमें वो मार्किंग स्कीम भी वैसी है, 3 पॉइंट्स को 2, 3 मार्क्स, 6 पॉइंट के लिए जितने मार्क्स है तो वो पॉइंट से लिखना।
ओके सर। तो एक लास्ट क्वेश्चन, अगर मेरे को हिस्ट्री एंड पॉलिटिकल में 40 आउट ऑफ 40 स्कोर करना है तो मुझे सबसे ज्यादा ध्यान क्या रखना चाहिए पेपर लिखने वक्त?
ओके, जो मैंने पहले जो वर्ड कहा था, देखा प्रेजेंटेशन। ओके
ओके,
फर्स्ट प्रेजेंटेशन करना, ट्राई करोगे आप कैंसिलेशन कहीं ना करना। ओके कोई भी ऐसे मिस्टेक्स कैंसिलेशन नहीं, और आपके जो आंसर्स है टू द पॉइंट, मुझे ऑब्जेक्टिव 3 मार्क का 3 मार्क्स मिलेगा, मुझे आइडेंटिफाई द रॉन्ग पे वहां पे करेक्ट मिलेगा मुझे, एवरीथिंग हैज टू बी वेरी सिस्टमैटिक। बॉर्डर निकालना दोनों साइड, एक साइड निकालो, क्वेश्चन नंबर सही है, अनटैडीनेस नहीं है, सभी पॉइंट्स को आप कवर कर रहे हैं, क्योंकि 40 आउट ऑफ 40 जो पेपर होते हैं वो होते हैं टॉप किस पेपर्स। इसको बोर्ड में हम उसको अलग उससे इसको उसका ये होता है बाद में, सो टॉप किस पेपर में 40 आउट ऑफ 40, तो आपका हैंड राइटिंग, आपके आंसर्स कितने करेक्ट है टू द क्वेश्चन देखा जाता है, आपका डायग्राम्स कितने प्रेजेंटेशन वाइज है, कितनी नीट है, सिस्टमेटिक है, ये सभी चीज को ध्यान करके फिर चीफ मॉनिटर मॉडिटर्स को कंसिडर करते हैं 40 मार्क्स ऑफ 40 देने के लिए। ओके
ओके सर, थैंक यू सर।
मेरा सेशन, डिड यू एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड जो मैंने भी लेक्चर लिया?
यस सर, वेरी वेरी,
थैंक यू माय डियर, गॉड ब्लेस यू एंड ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स फॉर योर सक्सेस। यस, नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन मैम।
यस संजना,
yes Sanjana, you can ask me a question.
Sir, I am Ganesh.
Okay Ganesh, tell me. Yes Ganesh.
Sir, I just want to know the reduced chapters of history.
Okay. Okay, you want to know the reduced chapters of history. Okay, see, there are 2 chapters have been reduced, deleted completely as per the 25% reduce. One is history of Indian arts, that is chapter number 4. Chapter number 6, entertainment and history. This is from history. Political science, the last chapter has been reduced completely. Challenges faced by the Indian democracy. Okay, Ganesh?
Okay, sir.
Sir, here. Sir, sorry to interrupt you. Rokde sir here. I would like to know this Ganesh is from which school? Ganesh, can you hear me? Ganesh?
Yes, sir, I can hear you.
You are from which school, Ganesh?
Sir, I am from Sodawala Lane Municipal English School, Borivali West.
Okay. Thank you, Ganesh. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Continue, sir. Continue. Yeah. Please continue.
Yeah. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Yes. Next question, my dear. There are few more students who have raised the hand. I think
Mahika Chaurasia.
Yeah. Good evening to you, Mahika. Yeah. Tell me.
Hello, sir.
Yes, tell me. Hello.
We can't write answers in our own word.
Yeah, you can write in your own word, but when they write in your own word, there is a little bit thing is that because it's a history. If there is anything which is not relevant, you will lose your mark. You have to be very thorough with your presenting their own answers, because everywhere you cannot write in your own words history. Some of the question, open-ended question, that question you can put down. But suppose you're writing for a give reason, answer briefly. The sentence formation has to be so good, and some of the words, some of the concept has to be there, which is from the history. You cannot just write entirely on your own. Framing will do, but certain things like important date, name of a person, how do you frame? It has to interconnected with that particular question has to be correct. You can write, but it depends upon whether you are so confident, know the answer relevant. Because some of the questions, there are certain things are genuinely wanted, which is they mention in the text, because history cannot be manipulated or you cannot change it. Okay, so this make a note. Okay.
Okay. Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you. Next question.
Muskan.
Yes, Muskan.
Hello, sir.
Hello, good evening to you, Muskan. Yeah.
Sir, question answers में यानी 2 marks के लिए और 4 marks के लिए और 3 marks के लिए कितने points लिखने के board में मतलब marks मिलेंगे full marks?
Full marks जैसे मैंने कहा कि जैसे marks दिए allotment किया है 4 marks का है तो at least write 2 points, 3 points write. If 8 marks के लिए तो 6 points लिखना चाहिए ना, 6 or 8 points. Points लिख 6 sentences, 25 to 30 words. अगर write short notes है तो write 4 points. Back to max 4 points तो आना ही चाहिए. और बड़े आंसर जो 8 मार्क्स के कम से कम 8 पॉइंट्स 10 पॉइंट्स उसमें दिखाने चाहिए बिकॉज व्हेन यू राइट 8 to 10 मे बी दैट यू आर यू इट विल कवर अप द एंटायर क्वेश्चन वी हैव जैसे आपने कवर किया है इफ यू राइट खाली 2 पॉइंट्स और उसको कैरी करता है 4 मार्क यू विल नॉट गेट द मार्क्स आधा मार्क मिलेगा और 1 मार्क मिलेगा तो 6 और 8 लाइंस तो आपका सेंटेंस पैराग्राफ पॉइंट्स तो आना ही चाहिए तभी आपको वो मार्क्स मिलते हैं पूरे फिर उसमें और वो भी जो करेक्ट हो तो या ओके मुस्कान
ओके सर थैंक यू
या दिस रेहान ओवर देयर रेटिंग हैज रेज्ड हैंड
यस रेहान
हेलो सर
हां रेहान टेल मी रेहान
क्वेश्चन नंबर 8 बी का डू एज डायरेक्ट वापस बता दो
डू एज डायरेक्टेड एज इंस्ट्रक्टेड ओके उसको क्या बता दो टेल मी
इसमें क्या करने का है
देखो हाँ रेहान देखो इसमें डायग्राम दिया रहेगा उसमें फ्लो चार्ट रहेगा टाइमलाइन रहेगा फिर उसमें बॉक्सेस रहेंगे तो आपको वो डायग्राम को ड्रॉ करना है जैसा दिया वैसा ड्रॉ करना है उसको हाफ मार्क फॉर ईच डायग्राम है उसमें तो आपको वो ड्रॉ करना है नीटली ड्रॉ विद द पेन और उसके आंसर्स भी पेन में लिखना है रेहान ये ध्यान देखो ऐसा ड्रॉ करना है जैसे मैंने कहा ना ये क्वेश्चन ये डायग्राम डू एज डायरेक्टेड समझ में आ गया डायग्राम रहे अब ये डायग्राम इसमें दिखाया क्योंकि डायग्राम टाइमलाइन आ सकता है फ्लो चार्ट आ सकता है फिर डायग्राम तो आपके टेक्स्टबुक में जितने डायग्राम है सभी को प्रैक्टिस करना और फिर आपको आंसर्स के साथ लिख के प्रैक्टिस करो तभी आपको ये फुल मार्क्स मिलेंगे आपको 2 मार्क ओके
सर डायग्राम पेन से बनाने का या फिर पेंसिल से
पेन से करो पेन से आंसर्स लिखो ठीक है
यस सर
ओके
थैंक यू सर
थैंक यू Yeah, another one. Dhanalakshmi is there.
Dhanalakshmi.
Good evening. Sir, मुझे ना identify the wrong pair ना समझाए नहीं क्या करना
उसको. Identify the wrong pair. Okay. Now see, identify the wrong pair. The question is which one? The question that is question number 1, B. Okay. Just one second. I'll show you the slide only, so you will be able to understand. 2 minutes. ये जो क्वेश्चन है आपको क्या करना है कि पहले तो जो 4 उसमें 4 ऑप्शन देंगे आप उसमें से एक को सिलेक्ट करना है दिस वन ये देखो ये दिख रहा है स्क्रीन पे अभी आइडेंटिफाई एंड रीराइट द रॉन्ग पेयर दिख रहा है स्क्रीन पे ओके अभी 4 जो है इसमें से जो रॉन्ग पेयर है उसको पूरा लिखना है ऐसा लिखना है आंसर है देखो पंडित रमाबाई श्री पुरुष तुलना ये गलत आंसर है आपको सिर्फ रॉन्ग पेयर लिखना है करेक्ट नहीं करना है ये ध्यान दीन बंधु गोपाल हरि देशमुख रॉकट के माथेरान ये है 3 मार्क का क्वेश्चन 3 आइडेंटिफिकेशन ये क्वेश्चन ऐसे पेपर में आएंगे आपको इसमें 4 में से एक को सिलेक्ट करना है पंडित रमाबाई तो पंडित रमाबाई श्री पुरुष तुलना दीन बंधु गोपाल हरि देशमुख ये है उसके आंसर्स तो गलत पेयर है समझ लो मैच द फॉलोइंग तो ये पे गलत मैचिंग दिया है पंडित रमाबाई श्री पुरुष तुलना नहीं है उसको आपको करेक्शन करना है तो उतना ही लिखना है नीचे पंडित रमाबाई स्त्री पुरुष तुलना लेकिन उससे पहले एक लिखना है रॉन्ग पेयर क्वेश्चन पंडित रमाबाई स्त्री पुरुष तुलना अभी समझा आई थिंक शी लॉस्ट कनेक्टिविटी आई थिंक सो ओके सुफियान यस मैम
सर आई वांट टू आस्क दैट If the diagram is an ellipse, so how can we draw it?
Just tell me, if the diagram is, just repeat your question, my dear. If the question,
Diagram is an ellipse, elliptic shape.
Ellipsis shapes, okay. But rarely, I think right now, it never happened that children are not facing that issue. We have last 5-year paper, the easier, I would say better, 3-diagram and flowchart diagrams have come, and boxes one. Never such complicated diagram, never till now. If it comes, I mean, you have to just, that's your thinking now, how you will use it, your skill. But till now, if you just go to the last 5-year question bank, you will always find the diagram has always come in a, like, it's this. This you can draw, no? this you can draw. I don't think any. So maximum these are the paper. If you go to the paper, this way it is.
So instead of ellipse, can we draw that box or a bracket?
Yeah.
Or
if it is, shape? It is. Yeah, yeah. So that particular diagram, you can go for it. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Students, we move on to the next question. Let me tell you, the same presentation will be shared with you all by your school subject teacher. Okay?
Thank you, madam. Thank you. Yes, Shweta.
Sir?
Yes, yes. Who's this? Shweta is speaking.
Sir, जो science के question answer होते हैं वो digest में से ही आता है क्या?
No, I use the word digest? No. I never use the word. Nothing comes from digest, my dear. Everything comes from textbook.
इसलिए मैंने कहा. Sir, हम लोग ऐसे भी लिख सकते हैं ना कि अरे मतलब उसका मतलब मेरे को अच्छे से पता है और अपने मन से लिखना है वो पूरा concept पता है.
हाँ, अगर आपने मन से भी लिखा है लेकिन उसमें अगर उसमें वो सेंसिबिलिटी है थोड़ा करेक्ट है टू द वो क्वेश्चन रेलेवेंट जा रहा है तो आपको मार्क्स मिलेंगे. ओके कोशिश करो टेक्स्ट बुक ही पढ़ो. टेक्स्ट बुक में सभी आंसर्स मिलते हैं. रेफर योर टेक्स्ट बुक. जब आप अलग अलग डाइजेस्ट खरीदते हैं ना तो कंफ्यूज हो जाएंगे. इसमें 6 पॉइंट है, इसमें 8 पॉइंट है. डोंट डू. रीड योर टेक्स्ट बुक. आपको और इंग्लिश और इसमें जो इंग्लिश में जो लैंग्वेज दी है टेक्स्ट बुक में काफी ईजी है. थोड़ा सा आप रीड करो, आपको आंसर्स वही मिलेंगे और वही लिखो, आपको मार्क्स मिलेंगे. अगर उसमें आप अपने खुद से लिख रहे हो, अगर रेलेवेंट है कॉन्सेप्ट को, आपको मार्क्स दिया जाता है.
ओके सर.
ओके
सर, मतलब
हाँ बोलो. हाँ श्वेता.
सर, लर्न करने में थोड़ा प्रॉब्लम होता है ना, इसलिए बोल रही थी अपने उसका पूरा कॉन्सेप्ट पता रहेगा, अपने मन से लिख सकते
हैं. हाँ, यू कैन राइट. यू कैन फॉर एग्जांपल टेलीविजन. अगर आपने टेलीविजन में कुछ चैनल्स के भी नाम डाल दिए, जैसे हिस्ट्री चैनल है, डिस्कवरी चैनल है, एपिक चैनल, एडिशनल, तो ये आपने मन से लिखा है तो आपको मार्क्स दिया जाता है. नो प्रॉब्लम.
ओके सर, जो आपने यहाँ पे लिंक भेजा ना वो सेंड कर सकते हो क्या ग्रुप पे?
That I think your teachers will do the part or jo in charge is hamare aaj ke lectures ke wo aapko karenge baad mein guide. Okay, don't worry.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you. Yes, the next question, ma'am. Yeah. Yeah, any more questions from students? Yes, Aditya has raised the hand. Yes, Vinit. Yeah, anyone who can ask me a question?
Asma.
Hello, sir. Good evening. Yes.
Good evening to you, Asma. Tell me.
Sir, हमारे पास 2 घंटा रहता है पेपर लिखने के लिए, जिसमें हमारे 9 questions होते हैं. तो हम किस क्वेश्चन में कितना टाइम लगा सकते हैं जिससे हमारा पूरा पेपर हो जाए?
Okay, Asma, ये अच्छा क्वेश्चन पूछा आपने. मैंने एक वर्ड यूज किया था, टाइम मैनेजमेंट. पेपर लिखने की एक आर्ट होता है, टाइम कला है. एक्चुअली प्रेजेंटेशन भी एक आर्ट है. क्या करना आसमा कि अभी ना स्पेसिमेन पेपर्स और आपके जो स्कूल्स है, अभी जैसे इन्होंने जैसे रोकड़े सर ने कहा कि प्रैक्टिस लेने वाले ये पेपर अब जब सॉल्व करेंगे ना, खुद का जजमेंट लेने का. हर एक बच्चे का मैंने कहा है कि स्पीड अलग अलग है, उसको जजमेंट अलग. जब आप 4-5 पेपर सॉल्व करेंगे ना तो आपको अपने आप मालूम पड़ेगा कि कौन से क्वेश्चन में कितने टाइम जा रहा है मेरा, क्या हो रहा है, कहाँ मैं वीक हो रही हूँ, कहाँ मेरा टाइम ज्यादा कंज्यूम हो रहा है. तो ये आपका जजमेंट आपको खुद लेना है. जब पेपर सॉल्व करेंगे 2 घंटे का टाइम वॉच रखो और डैडी मम्मी को बोलो, डैडी मम्मी मेरे को 2 घंटे के बाद स्टॉप करने को बोलो, तो कितना होता है क्वेश्चन. ये प्रैक्टिस करना पड़ेगा आपको. जब आप दो या तीन पेपर का आपको मालूम पड़ेगा कि मैं स्लो जा रही हूँ, तो नेक्स्ट प्रैक्टिस पेपर में स्पीड बढ़ाओ. कहाँ बढ़ाने का है, आपकी हैंड राइटिंग नहीं चेंज होना चाहिए, ये आपके ऊपर है आसमा. इट्स ऑल डिपेंड अपॉन यू, बिकॉज हर एक स्किल, एवरी चाइल्ड हैज ओन वे ऑफ स्पीड ऑफ राइटिंग द पेपर विद गुड हैंड राइटिंग. तो जब पेपर सॉल्व करेंगे आपको, डेफिनेटली आपको वो व्हाट यू कॉल इट एक्सपीरियंस आ जाएगा कि नहीं मुझे अभी यहाँ पे मुझे स्पीड बढ़ाना है, मुझे ये कवर करना है. और मैंने जैसे कहा कि पेपर लास्ट मिनट तक नहीं लिखना है, 10 मिनट या 5 मिनट पहले पेपर खत्म होना चाहिए आपका, क्योंकि आपको उसको गो थ्रू भी करना है. सो इट अप टू यू आसमा. ठीक है, ओके रोशनी, नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन.
Hello. Good evening, sir.
Good evening to you, my dear. Tell me.
Sir, वो एट्थ का फोर्थ चैप्टर और सिक्स्थ चैप्टर वो एग्जाम में आएगा कि नहीं?
नहीं आएंगे, जो रिड्यूस किया है एसएससी बोर्ड ने 25% रिड्यूस पोर्शन जो है उसमें से कोई भी क्वेश्चन नहीं आएगा बोर्ड में. चैप्टर नंबर फोर जो है हिस्ट्री ऑफ इंडियन आर्ट्स और एंटरटेनमेंट एंड हिस्ट्री, इसमें से कोई भी क्वेश्चन नहीं आएंगे.
पॉलिटिकल टाइम भी है ना?
हाँ, लास्ट चैप्टर जो है इंडियन चैलेंजेस ऑफ डेमोक्रेसी वो भी नहीं आएगा. ओके
अच्छा ठीक है, थैंक यू.
रोशनी, व्हाट इज द नेम ऑफ योर स्कूल? रोशनी बेटा प्लीज टेल मी द नेम ऑफ योर स्कूल. रोशनी, यू आर फ्रॉम विच स्कूल? कैन यू हियर मी रोशनी?
आई थिंक सर शी हैज म्यूटेड. आई थिंक सर
ओके, नो इश्यू, कंटिन्यू.
यस सर. Yeah, see, clear the doubt, children, because this is a moment you can clear so that you can, in the upcoming papers, you can write and get your own marks, the feedback from the teachers, and you can improve also. So, doubts clear, my dear children. I'm there with you. Yes, we have a Sammy and I think Gupta. Yeah.
Sir?
हाँ बोलो.
गुड इवनिंग.
गुड इवनिंग टू यू माय डियर. गुड इवनिंग
सर. अगर पॉइंट्स ऊपर नीचे होंगे तो चलेगा?
पॉइंट्स ओके. जो सी वे अब जो पॉइंट्स लिखते हैं ऊपर नीचे वही क्वेश्चन पे अगर करेक्ट है नो प्रॉब्लम. अब एंड में वो स्टेटमेंट को कवर करना है, गिव रीजन में हो या जो भी क्वेश्चन, उसको दस द अबव स्टेटमेंट इज, ये स्टेटमेंट है उसको कवर करो आप. Upper niche points doesn't make a difference. If it is relevant to that particular question, the marks will be given. Chalega upper niche point.
Aur sir, agar apne onwards mein likhenge to as it and agar upper niche hoga to bhi chalega na?
Chalega. Lekin ye dhyan mein rehna hai ki jab onwards mein likhte ho children, ki history change nahi honi chahiye. Because aapko history change nahi kar sakte aap. Aapko onwards mein sentence form karo, lekin kuch keywords jo hai wo usme aana chahiye. वो क्वेश्चन आंसर्स लिखते वक्त यू कैन नॉट चेंज द एंटायर थिंग. पूरा नहीं चेंज कर सकते, थोड़ा सा सेंटेंस फॉर्मेशन आप चेंज कर सकते हैं, फ्रेमिंग, बट कुछ जो इंपॉर्टेंट वर्ड्स है, इंपॉर्टेंट मैंने पहले भी कहा डेट्स है, इंपॉर्टेंट कुछ बुक्स के नाम लिखना है, तो वो आपको एज इट इज लिखना है, तभी आपको मार्क्स मिलेंगे. पूरा मन से पेपर आपको नहीं लिख सकते, क्योंकि ऐसी राइटिंग नहीं है कि निबंध लिख रहे हैं आप. आपको वो हिस्ट्री पेपर लिख रहे, तो आपको सर्टन थिंग्स तो करेक्ट ही चाहिए ना, जो एज पर द टेक्सचुअल जो टेक्स्ट बुक में दिया है. तो वैसे इसे इसे मैंने कहा है कि टेक्स्ट बुक पढ़ो, क्योंकि सर्टन थिंग्स टेक्स्ट बुक्स में वो क्लियरली मेंशन किया कि ये पॉइंट आना ही चाहिए. तब जब वो पॉइंट उसमें रहेगा तो मार्क्स मिलेगा आपको, नहीं तो पॉइंट नहीं है और आप खुद से मन से लिखते जा रहे 8 पॉइंट 10 पॉइंट, उसके कुछ मीनिंग ही नहीं, फिर आपको मार्क्स ही नहीं मिलेंगे. समझा? इज इट क्लियर? थैंक यू. या एनी मोर क्वेश्चंस?
Hello, sir.
Yes, good evening to you, my dear. Tell me.
Good evening, sir. Sir, paper agar cursive mein likhe to chalega na?
Cursive. Actually, what happened, my dear children, now nobody writes cursive. I'll tell you frankly. Most of the children are writing in the plain, plain font. But if the cursive, a habit of writing cursive, agar aapne likha, isse pehle aap paper likhte cursive mein?
Yes, okay. I also know that cursive only, no?
Yeah, so you know cursive. If your cursive is very good, legible है, clear है, आपने लिखा हुआ, तो exam में कोई problem नहीं read करने में, तो आपको paper will be evaluated. Don't worry, because you are used to cursive. But maximum जैसे as a moderator I'm telling you, जितने papers हम evaluate करते हैं, सब लोग बच्चे plain simple handwriting में लिखते हैं English, plain font में. अगर आप लिखते हो cursive में, ये ध्यान में रखना कि आपकी font और आपकी handwriting cursive की change नहीं होना चाहिए. It should be clear for the examiner or moderator to give you the mark. Otherwise illegible handwriting, you may lose your marks. Okay, so अच्छा font लिखो बड़ा, cursive will do. Okay.
Okay, sir. Okay, thank you, sir.
Thank you, thank you.
Okay, students. We have shared.
Any last question, ma'am? We can take it. One query, last one.
Yeah. Why not, sir?
Just one. I think someone just said.
Hello. Good morning. Good evening, sir.
Good evening to you, my dear.
सर अगर ट्रू और फॉल्स में अगर फॉल्स स्टेटमेंट है तो हम लोग को उसको रीराइट करके लिखना पड़ेगा क्या ट्रू सेंटेंस में
नो व्हाई द स्टेटमेंट इज फॉल्स यू हैव टू जस्ट राइट द रीजन ओवर देयर ओके
सर
ओनली रीजन यू हैव टू लिखना लेकिन जो अबाउ स्टेटमेंट इज फॉल्स उसको अंडरलाइन करो और व्हाई इट इज फॉल्स उसका रीजन लिखो टू पॉइंट्स में फिर उससे कवर करो उसको सो द स्टेटमेंट इज फॉल्स ऐसा लिखना है
ओके सर
ओके हां Yeah, ma'am, can I say a few words?
Yes, why not, sir? Please.
I really want to thank, first of all, the Honorable Roopesh sir and the entire team of Brihanmumbai Mahanagar Secondary Section and the Vrushali madam and all the CNOs who are dignitaries. And I forgot one name to appreciate, that is Mr. Mayur sir for the good, wonderful banner. I mean, I really appreciate the entire technical team. Zadov sir also, and I heartily thank Superintendent sir, Shah, Roopesh sir, thank you very much once again to giving me this opportunity for sharing my knowledge and experience to the wonderful students of yours. Thank you, sir, and thank you very much, sir. Yes, ma'am.
Yes, as we are have a shortage of time, really thank you very much for that one-to-one interaction with our students and my dear students this entire presentation will be there with you by tomorrow so don't worry you can see this presentation on our YouTube channel so it's always there with you okay and now I request Ms. Bhavya to please deliver a vote of thanks and one more thing There is one attendance link is there in chat box. So please, all the participants, copy that link and fill and please submit because your attendance is going to matter, right? Yes, yeah. sir. Over to you, Bhavya, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Good evening, everyone, again. It gives me an immense pleasure to deliver a vote of thanks for today's orientation program. First of all, I would like to thank our today's chief guest, Robin George, sir. Sir, today's lecture was very informative and full of knowledge, especially highlighting the points like importance of time management, marks allotted for each question, how to score full marks for each question, as well as on how to present the answer paper. So, it will definitely help our 10th standard students to achieve 100% results. I would also like to thank our inspiration education officer, Honorable Sri Raju Tadvi sir, Deputy Education Officer, Srimati Mamta Rao madam, and Superintendent Sri Mukhtar Shah sir. I would also like to thank our beat officer, Honorable Sri Vishwas Ropre sir, and AO Sri Vijay Jadhav sir. I would also like to thank our subject head, Prajakta Mali ma'am, Standard 10 CNO, Vrushali Desai ma'am, Assistant CNO, Harshada Tavde ma'am, and Rohit Kulkarni sir, and Mayur Vandane sir for technical support. I would also like to thank all my dear students and colleague teacher for joining today's orientation program. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. All the best to the students, my dear. God bless you. And may you get a successful result. And thanks to the entire dignitary officers once again, the entire CNO, entire team. And thank you very much, sir.
Thank you, Bhavya ma'am, in generous words. Respected Roopesh sir, George sir, and my teammates, with your permission, I declare that today's session is completed. Sir?
Yes, ma'am.
Roopesh sir, can we end the meeting? Okay, just a minute.